At a cemetery in Barcelona, trucks arrive for a court-ordered exhumation. All across Spain, officials are opening the coffins of dead newborn babies to see if there are any babies inside, because the Spanish have discovered that many of the coffins are empty. Spain is reeling from one of the worst crimes since World War II. It's known simply as the stolen babies. The sheer scale of it is staggering. It is a story horrifying in its magnitude. Hundreds of thousands of Spanish babies taken from their mothers at birth and sold on the black market. Beginning during the Franco dictatorship in 1939 and continuing until the 1990s, newborns were stolen from hospitals and trafficked by a secret network of doctors, nurses, priests, and nuns. It began as a way to take children from families considered politically dangerous to the fascist Franco regime, to re-educate them. In many cases, the attending nurse would take the newborn from the mother to have it examined or cleaned, and would return with a dead baby that was kept in a freezer at the hospital as proof that the child had died. Then a coffin would be buried that contained only rocks or perhaps a severed limb from another patient. What began as a system of political control gradually turned into a giant money-making operation. And it never came to light until a man named Juan Luis Moreno sat by his father's deathbed and was told that both he and his childhood friend Antonio Barroso were purchased from a nun.
It was horrible. First to know that my father was dying, but then to learn that he wasn't my real father and that my best childhood friend was stolen just like I was.
When I was a boy, other boys at school said that my mother wasn't my real mother. I asked her and she said, "Of course you're my son." But when I did a DNA test with my mother, the probability of maternity was 0%.
Antonio started ANADER, an association fighting for justice for the victims of this scandal.
I realized I needed to establish an association to see if the courts would pay attention, because they were ignoring us.
And as their story spread through the media, more and more Spanish women who believe their babies were stolen have started to come forward.
I am Praxi Maxia. I'm looking for my daughter born in 1982. Like the others, I saw her at birth and I didn't see her again. They told me she had died.
I am looking for my brother, who was born in July 1971.
I believe that Spain was a supermarket for babies, for Spaniards themselves and for the rest of the world.
The Spanish have started to examine death certificates and adoption papers and have found that many have been falsified, and not very creatively. This adoption paper says the child's biological parents were Mary and Joseph. The use of Mary and Joseph was common.
The crimes were committed for money. There was no criminal organizations with a mafia boss in charge. Every hospital had its own business.
We sat down with some of the victims, women looking for their parents, a brother or a sister, or their children. All feel the government is dragging its feet.
Sometimes we feel as if they are playing with us. We want real justice and brave judges. We want the government to support us because they have the strength.
It's a black hole. We need to know where our sisters, brothers, and in the case of the mothers, where their babies, that nowadays they are not babies, they are adults.
Enrique Vila is a lawyer and author of a best-selling book about the stolen babies.
Spanish justice is deceiving us. They deceive by giving the image that they are working to resolve this problem, that they are investigating it. It's a good political image to show the rest of the world.
Rumors of stolen babies had circulated in Spain for decades, but the cases have not gone to court until this year.
It seems incredible that there are doctors, there are medical assistants, there are nurses, there are nuns who are still loose on the street, who have stolen children and become rich with millions of pesetas and then euros, and they had not yet been arrested or detained or put in prison. This I don't think would happen in any other country.
Vila does not believe the thefts were a policy of the Catholic Church, but he wonders if the church hierarchy knew about it and looked the other way. Church officials deny it. Spain is today a nation of many tortured souls, people who once thought they knew who they were. and have discovered that they are someone else.
You find out about this big lie that they sold Antonio and me. It's a crime. It's the buying and selling of babies, like someone who just buys a computer. It's horrible.
I cry every night when I go to sleep for my daughter. When she was born, I could not hug her. I only had her on my breast. They put her there while they cut the umbilical cord. They cut the cord and they took her, and I didn't see her again.
Even if the Spanish legal system gets to the bottom of this scandal, it can never repair the damage done to so many Spanish mothers and the children they never knew. Dale Hurd, CBN News, Valencia, Spain.